As far as the fight is concerned, thank God so few people bought the pay-per-view, because that certainly didn't do very much for the sport of boxing.
Nonito just finished fighting last week, and you were very pleased with that. He says it was the last fight at that division because they move up. You want to talk about that?
Well, that's right. We're going to look to have Donaire fight for a 122-pound title, maybe against Nishioka.
Okay. Your next fighter, Bennis, is fighting also. Let me ask you this. There's been a lot of rumors that Bennis is ready to fight Saul from Golden Boy Promotions, from his champion. Are you going to work hard to make that fight? Are you going to try to press WBC to make that fight? What's going on there?
Well, it looks like Alvarez will only take on guys 108 pounders. So, what are you going to do? I mean, Sal Alvarez has a lot of problems, more than Vanes Medrosian.
And for last, Julio Cesar Chavez is coming back. He didn't fight in Mexico, he's going to fight in the United States. Talk about that in the future.
We were in Houston yesterday. Tremendous turnout. We're going to sell out the building. It's going to be a very, very good fight, and it'll be seen on HBO on November 19th.
Will there be any chance to bring Julio here before that fight?
Bring
Julio here to Los Angeles.
He'll be here this afternoon. He's living in LA now.
What?
So he's training here.
What Floyd did in that fight, did that tarnish his legacy any more than you think it's already?
For me, fuck the legacy. He cheated the public.
Can you talk about Pacquiao Marquez? How pivotal was that second fight was in Pacquiao's career?
That fight could have gone either way. So could the first fight go either way.
But that sort of like launched his career, because then he went against...
No, it didn't launch his career. Mm-hmm. What launched his career was the David Diaz fight. Mm-hmm. When he showed that he could fight a bigger guy, and he finally was able, thanks to Freddie, to use his right hand.